In this video, you'll learn about the pecuniary and non-pecuniary benefits of employment. To understand this topic, we have to answer this question. What is it that attracts you to a job? Is it just money or is it something else? When we answer this question, we are thinking about both the pecuniary and non-pecuniary benefits of labor. Ultimately, we assess the attractiveness of a job by looking at both. Now let's look at what is meant by the term net advantages with respect to employment. Employment has benefits that include both pecuniary and non-pecuniary benefits. When deciding on whether to offer their labor or not, an individual will consider both benefits, both pecuniary and non-pecuniary benefits. The net advantage of working in a specific occupation or position are what will influence the individual's decision. Pecuniary benefits are the monetary benefits of working, such as wages, salary, overtime, bonuses, and commissions. Essentially, pecuniary benefits include the direct financial compensation received for work. Money is not always enough to entice people into a position. Individuals will consider many other factors as well. Non-pecuniary benefits are non-monetary and include job satisfaction, job security, paid vacation time, location, and various other non-monetary perks. A great example of a job with many non-pecuniary benefits is teaching. The job can be quite satisfying to many, and it has more days off than other occupations. In general, teaching also provides strong job security. Thus, it's safe to say that people choose positions based on financial and non-financial benefits. Let's look at a hypothetical situation an individual may find themselves in. If they need to choose between these two positions, they would need to consider the entire offer before choosing which job to take. The account management position has a total possible compensation of $70,000, whereas a high school teacher will earn only $45,000. With respect to pecuniary benefits, the account management position is more attractive. Now let's look at some of the non-pecuniary benefits, specifically working days per year, job stability, and job satisfaction. The teacher will have less working days per year, higher job stability, and satisfaction. Which position will be chosen will be determined by what the individual values. Someone who is more financially motivated may choose the account management position, whereas someone who values job stability, job satisfaction, and leisure time more highly would become a teacher. Once we establish the key factors influencing an individual's decision, we would have better insight into which way they would choose. You should have a clear understanding of what is meant by the pecuniary and non-pecuniary benefits of employment by now. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and let's try to resolve these together. That's us done for now, and I will see you in the next one.